Welcome to Synergy Practices Podcast.
Red card segment brought to you by Arminco Inc. Synergy Practices. My name is Darwin. We have another red card segment yet again. Sasha and Artin are joining me. So Sasha, let's go ahead and get started. Take me through it.
All right. So what I got for you guys today is we had a call come in from a doctor, actually calling from the Richmond area. He's an endodontist who was looking to build out a 1,900 square foot space and kind of got himself into a little bit of a jam. And let me run it by you guys. So he gave us a call when he was looking at leasing the space. A couple of the local experts, if you will, quote unquote, told him it was going to be around $100 a square foot for construction. Now that the lease is signed and he's getting bids, it's coming out to be around $240,000 to $250,000, which is obviously way above $100 a square foot for 1,900 square feet. So take us through it, Art. What happened here? What could have been done? Where's the red card?
Well, I mean, obviously the red card is the fact that either A, the doctor did not do the due diligence properly, or was misled if he had hired someone that gave him a bad advice. A lot of times what happens is people listen to what they want to listen to and kind of ignore the facts. So we don't know who said what, but I have heard in the industry a lot of equipment people say this. I've also heard some bankers say it. I've heard some realtors say it, where they're using $100 square foot as a rule of thumb, and it's just such a loose number. And when people call us, and Sasha, you know this, Darwin, you know this, we get calls all the time, how much you charge per square foot? It's not a square foot price when you're doing construction, because there's a lot of things that are related. You know, a doctor might be talking to me and I might say, yeah, this building, if you're thinking about coming in this building, you might spend $100 square foot. However, that doesn't mean it's going to cost him anywhere he goes $100 square foot. If he goes to a different building, it might cost him $120 square foot, right? So it all depends on the space that they have. We have scenarios and situations. We have a course. We do a lot of study clubs where we try to teach and educate people on what to look for when they're talking to, when they're looking at spaces to know how much their costs are going to be, because it really depends. You can go into a space that's a raw shell, no air conditioning unit, no electrical panel, no concrete slab floor, right? Right there, we have about a $50,000 cost that if you go into a space that already has an air conditioning unit, already has a electrical panel box that's sufficient enough for you, mm-hmm. and has a concrete slab, right? So right there, you got about $50,000 difference. So, you know, which one? Obviously, the second one is going to be costing you less, closer to $100 square foot. The first option I gave you is going to cost you more than $100 square foot, right? But you offset that by, you know, we've had other episodes and we talked about TI money, tenant improvement. You offset that by requiring or requesting more TI money, less lease rate, so that you're negotiating with the landlord, so that overall your numbers match, so to speak.
I think everybody's trying to capture that lead, you know, and sometimes it means giving information without really knowing all of the details, like you're saying. And we haven't even talked about being able to identify that doctor that has a specialty. We've mentioned it many times in our podcast. Specialty doctors require different plumbing, like you're saying, different requirements, door sizes, things that these folks aren't even taking in consideration or even thinking when they're just blurting out prices. It feels like we're fishing, we're throwing the worm out there. As long as we get it, hey, we're gonna capitalize. We'll figure out the rest along the way. And that's just not good business, because that's where the surprises come, and they're usually unpleasant, as we've talked about it many times.
And I will tell you, I mean, you're hitting right something that's very interesting. A lot of people, you know, a lot of times in this industry specifically, people like to say things just to show their knowledge. So again, they're using that $100 square foot very loosely. If anyone, you know, I've been doing construction for a long, long time. Someone asked me how much does it cost to build a dental office. I've never, ever, ever told them an exact price. I'm like, well, pick the building, pick the space, let me look at it, and I'll tell you how much it's going to be approximately, right? Because even just by looking at it, it's going to be approximately, because I still don't know your finishes, I don't know what you want to want to do. I don't know how many ops you want to want. I don't know how many things you're going to have. I don't know that. I'm generalizing, right? So before we even get to that space, we're generalizing the building. So out of thin air, I can't say how much per square foot. I've done spaces, and you guys know, and you guys have been with the company for a long time. We've done buildings and dental offices that have cost us $70 a square foot all the way to $250 a square foot, $300 a square foot, right? Depending on, you know, the size of the space, depending on the building, depending on what floor the space is on, depending on the condition of the space and the condition of the building, all that stuff matters. And one thing people don't understand is the bigger your square footage, generally speaking, the less per square foot cost you're going to have. Yeah. For example, if you have an identical location in the same building, holding everything constant, right? If you're looking at a 3,500 square foot of a space, your construction might be 320,000, 330,000. In that same building, if you're looking at a 1,500 square foot of space, your construction might be 200,000. So you see, on one side, you're at above $100 square foot. On the larger side, or on the larger scale, you're below the $100 square foot. And that's because when you're looking to do construction, there's some standard cost that regardless the square footage you're gonna have. For example, you need a air conditioner. Regardless if you're 1,500 square foot, 2,000 square foot, or 3,000 square foot, right? The size of the air conditioning might matter, but that doesn't add that much cost, right? It's, you still need the air conditioner. So, and proportionally, that's what happens. And that's why people get confused, and that's why people use, I'm against people that use that $100 square foot. I think it's a very misleading number, but I think it definitely happens in our industry, and you know, it could definitely frustrate a lot of clients.
Yeah, and one final note I want to just chime in about this $100 square foot number. You might also hear it from colleagues in the past. Again, like Art said, just because your friend built an office at $100, $110 a square foot doesn't mean, even if you're in the same city, it's going to be around the same cost. So I hear that a lot. I get a lot of questions. My friend 10 years ago built his office for $100 a square foot. What's the difference here?
Yeah. Well, I mean, just to take that, I've had best friends or sisters tell me, look, you build my sister's location, and it was way less than my location, right? It's all, you're right. The state matters, the location matters, the city matters, the county matters, all that stuff matters. And the best of it is, I've even had people call and they're like, how much does it cost? And then I'm like, how much does it cost to do what, right? And then they pull out a number from you, and then they start negotiating with you. I'm like, what are we negotiating? I'm like, doctor, let me flip this on you a little bit. I want to buy a car from you. I want it for $20,000. Are you going to give it to me? I haven't told you what car. I haven't told you what I want. What if I want a Ferrari for $20,000? Can you give me that? All right? So it's not a tangible item. There's a lot of variables to know how much per square foot.
It's the classic case of one size does not fit all. But let's back it up a little bit, guys. So we're in this situation, and we all know that when a doctor, a business owner, an entrepreneur is trying to get started, he's going to have all these questions. He's going to want to take the initiative to go and do some research. And unfortunately, he's going to also take himself into that situation where he's putting himself at risk to get right information, wrong information, some information in between. So let's back it up. What would you guys say if I'm a doctor and I'm starting my business and I have these questions and I really need these answers to get started and have a feel for what these prices are going to be? What would you do? Who do I bring along the way before I even ask that? What would I do differently? Or what would you recommend for me to do differently at that point?
That's a great question. My biggest recommendation is to talk to the experts related to that particular field. First, if you're opening up any type of business, you're looking at an overall budget. So let's say you're opening up a dental practice, and in this case, let's say it's an endo office, right? You wanna pinpoint down how much is it gonna take for you to open it up, right? Generally speaking, let's assume the number is 500,000, correct? Now, you wanna talk to specific experts in their field and get as much as information you can get to determine what the costs are going to be. For example, you don't need to talk to a bank to understand numbers of construction. Don't do that. That's the number one mistake people do, right? you know, or you don't need to talk to a consultant to tell you approximately what a construction cost you did. You need to talk to contractors specifically in the field that have done multiple dental offices that can give you the best possible outcome and tell you why. You got to ask questions. The why matters more than the number. How much does it take for me to build an office? If someone tells me $100 square foot, my next question is like, why? What are you including for the $100 square foot?
What does that mean?
Yeah. What if my space does not have air conditioning? Are you saying you're including that in it? Or are you saying, no, that's excluded? So that I understand what's happening, right? And vice versa. If you want equipment, don't go to your contractor and say, how much should I spend on equipment? Talk to an equipment person. Talk to four of them, three of them, five of them. But understand, get the why. Don't just say, oh, X product is the best product. That's why you want to get the product. Find out why it's the best product. Ask them why. Why? Because it's just popular? Because the name is out there? Or does it operate differently? Or is it really a good quality because it doesn't break down? Or when it breaks down, it's easier to fix, right? So all that stuff, that would be my best recommendation, is find out your budget around it, and then talk to the specific experts and find out the answers, and then don't be afraid to ask the question why, because that's what's going to save you, the why, not the answer. Don't just say, oh, I like his answer, it's $100 square foot, $90 square foot, I'm going to take that, you know, I'm going to build it around that, because a lot of people like to do that, right?
For sure. I like it. Yeah. All right.
Sounds good, yeah.
Thanks, everyone, for joining us. And please, if you haven't checked out our previous episodes, please do so. Search Synergy Practices Podcast. You'll be able to download those directly from the Apple Podcast, Google Podcast, and, of course, Spotify. Search Synergy Practices Podcast.